Remember the furore when entrepreneur Eddie Grove's company ABC Learning went to the wall back in late 2008, leaving families across Australia wondering what would happen to childcare? Well, today, the 650 remaining ABC Learning centres that have been owned since 2009 by the not-for-profit syndicate Goodstart Early Learning are rebranded. Now, the whole childcare sector faces drastic reform to meet new national quality standards from next year. I spoke to Goodstart Early Learning's Chief Executive Officer Julia Davison from Brisbane. Julia Davison, welcome to the programme.
Good evening.
Well, it's a good mission statement for Goodstart Early Learning, working towards the continuous pursuit of excellence in early childhood services through high quality training programmes that reflect the needs of the industry. How would you rate your performance against that mission?
I think, as you probably know, we're a new organisation that was set up to take over 650 of the failed ABC centres, and we've been working very hard over the last 15 months to improve the quality of our services. We've invested $10 million in training our staff, and we've been doing lots of things across the whole country. So I would say I think we've made a good start, yes. But there's still a lot for us to do.
No pun intended. Big changes this year, of course. We've got the first national quality standards coming through. Tell me, Julia, how much of a shock did you get when you opened the books of ABC Learning in terms of staff qualifications? Because it's something that Eddie Groves boasted about.
What I would say is that I think our staff qualifications reflect those of the rest of the sector. Australia does not have a highly qualified workforce compared with many countries in the rest of the world.
So you weren't shocked when you took over ABC Learning at the level of it?
No. And I myself knew that the workforce challenges are one of our biggest challenges. To meet the new national quality reforms at Goodstart, we need to employ 2,000 additional staff. Yeah. We have 1,700 staff with no qualifications, and we need to recruit an additional 500 teachers, but we're well down that track.
Mm. As I understand it, 30% of childcare workers across the sector don't have any formal qualifications. When you think of a teacher at school, they're required to have qualifications, they've got an ongoing programme of education, and yet childcare workers haven't had any of this before, and a lot of them are paid $15 an hour. It's a big change that's going to have to happen, isn't it?
It's a huge change, but from our perspective, a change that's a really important one. The first 5 years are really important, and they really make a difference to people's lives.
You're committed to making a difference with disadvantaged children in particular. You've got two levels to your business, don't you?
We do have a particular inclusion agenda, and that's about looking at what we can do to include more at-risk and vulnerable children in our centres. And that's not just disadvantaged children. We've been working with a number of other providers, talking to people who provide services for children with hearing disabilities, people who provide services for children with other disabilities, to try and make our services more accessible.
Your background is very much in the health sector, and I understand that these sorts of projects are being started in South Australia and Victoria rather than in Queensland, which is where Eddie Groves came from and ABC Learning came from. Yeah. Is there a reason for that? Is that because that's where you hail from?
No, the reason why we started in South Australia is we've got the highest number of centres in South Australia in low socioeconomic areas. So we've got six of our centres in South Australia are in C41 postcodes. So we thought that was a good place to start. It also gives us a good opportunity to connect up with other services. Victoria, we decided to pilot some of our inclusion initiatives because of some strong relationships we've got there, in particular with the Centre for Community Child Health.
There are suggestions that the pressure to raise fees, to get the ratios right, and to get qualified teachers on board will force children into backyard care. Do you think that's going to happen?
Look, we're doing everything we possibly can to minimise the impact on fees with our families. So our fees, in some of our centres, they won't go up at all in January. So not in, for example, in Western Australia, we already meet the ratios, the fees won't go up. In New South Wales, our fees went up last year. They went up on average around $2, and we didn't lose families there through the implementation of of the changes, and across the rest of the country, our fees will go up on average between $2 and $3 per child per day.
Finally, Eddie Groves and ABC Learning obviously left a very bitter taste in some people's mouths in terms of the subsidies that the company sucked up as a private company. Do you think this has damaged the reputation of private childcare?
I'm not familiar enough with the industry. I'm new to the industry. As you said, I'm from the health sector. But what I do know is that the ABC Learning brand is tarnished, and we know that from our own research when we've asked families if they'll consider enrolling their child in one of our centres. When we first asked families that, only 40% of families said yes. When we told them that the ABC Learning Centres were now owned by a company, that Goodstart, that was a not-for-profit, and we asked them, now that they knew that, would they consider enrolling their child, the number of families that said yes doubled. So I think that really tells
that
the story.
The question. All right. Julia Davison, thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Thank you very much.